Hi, this is a triple question on geometry, three questions back to back. Came in CAT previously. Let's see what this says. Not difficult. Let's see. Consider a cylinder of height h and radius is equal to 2 by pi centimeters as shown in the figure, not drawn to scale. A string of certain height when is wound on the cylindrical surface starting at point A, ending at point B, gives a minimum of maximum of n turns. In other words, the string length is the minimum required to wind n turns. Okay, so you have three questions based on this, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so let's see. What is the vertical spacing between two consecutive turns? So you are going to wind the string across it. Now, we know if I cut a cylinder, I'll get a rectangular place. This part will be 2 pi r. And this height is h. Now you're going to wind n number of times, so it will go here, then it will start from here, go here, that will start from here, go here, and it will keep on going till the last turn. It will go till this point, right? Now the question is, what is the vertical spacing between two turns, right? So you're dividing into n parts, height is h, so the vertical parts, vertical spacing between two consecutive terms will be h by n. Option A will be a correct choice. Pretty straightforward, right? You're dividing into n pieces, so h by n will be the length of each piece. Let's try the next one. Okay, the same string when wound on an exterior four walls of a cube of side n starting from point C ending at point D gave exactly one turn, not drawn to scale. The length of the string is how much? Okay, so let's draw this. You have something like this. If I take out the cube, you have the four surfaces wound around it. So 1, 2, 3. Okay, the side of the cube is n. So this is n. This part is 4n. Now, this will be the length of the string. It will go wind up like this. Just from here, it will go round and it will go somewhere around this way. It will be wound across the surface, right? This is how it will look like if I unravel the cube, right? So we need to find the length of the string. The length of the string will be, using Pythagoras theorem, one side is n, other side is 4n. So the hypotenuse will be n square plus 4n whole square, square root. So that gives you n into root 17, option B, right? Okay, and the last one says, in the setup of the two previous questions, how is h related to n? Now, I know the length of the string is this much, n root 17. And using this, I can find out the length of the string. Now, each round, this will all be identical, right? Again, using Pythagoras theorem, this will be h by n, right? This is h by n, and this part is 2 pi r, and r is 2 by pi. So this part is 4, this part is h by n. So one wind is square root of 4 square plus h square by n square. N such winds will be this much. This value equals root 17 n. So if I square this, you'll get 16 plus h square by n square equals 17. So h square by n square equals 1, which means h should be equal to n. Let's look at the option which says this. H should be equal to n. Option C is your correct choice. Right? Pretty straightforward question on volume, cylinders, but the biggest hero here is the Pythagoras theorem. Right? So that finishes this one.